Whoops. How do we turn this around? Here we go. Hi. Hey, everyone. I will be going live in a few moments with the beautiful Lisa Vidal, who plays Mari on The Baker and the Beauty. She's one of my favorite characters and favorite people. And I'm super excited for this chat because she's just a legend. Here she is. Hello. Hola, mommy.
Hi, Chula. How you doing?
Good.
Can you see me okay? Or is it like super hot? Hold on, let's see.
It's a little warm, but I want to ask everybody, right? How's this? Yeah, can you hear me good? Can everyone out there hear me good?
I can hear you. Okay. This is a little warm, honey. She said that this, I feel like, you know, I got that ring light that I work with. So it's like.
So tell me, is this better?
My husband's adjusting my light. Hold on, baby. It was too bright. That's a
Jay.
Say hi to Nat.
Hi, sweetie. How are you?
He's your lighting and your grip.
Aww.
He's just an all-around amazing husband. I feel like he has a lot of parallels to Daniel. We were talking about that.
Yeah.
What it's like to date, you know, or in your case, be married to a really strong, powerful, successful woman.
Ah. Okay.
Everybody who's tuning in now, Lisa's husband is so amazing. He's like such a rock and like just always supporting her and giving her love and praising her. And yeah, I can imagine that that's probably what Noah sees in Daniel too.
Absolutely.
A real good guy.
Aren't we all just looking for good guys, y'all? Come on now, girls. You know, we need some good guys. We need good guys. That's important. I feel like, you know, a lot of people ask Jay and I, because we've been together for like 35 years, and a lot of people are like, what's the secret? What's the secret? And I'm like, the secret is that marriage ain't easy. And you gotta know that. You know, you have ups and downs, and you have to laugh a lot and be friends and enjoy each other's
time. Gotta laugh a lot and have great sex.
Well, you guys heard it.
What do you think, Matt?
Well, I assume that there was something good going on if you guys have such a long and successful marriage. But I actually feel like when I watch you play Mari, how like you're so perfect for the role, because, and that's why I think people are really enjoying the show, because it actually is really rare to see people who are married and still happy and in love. Sadly, yeah. That's really rare these days, but you know, and it isn't perfect, but it's real and it's beautiful. I feel like I'm quoting Daniel from episode one. That was
right.
Exactly his line. But you really just bring that to the role. And that's why, like, I watch every time you and Carlos come on screen, I have the biggest smile on my face.
Aw, thank you, Nat. That means a lot to me.
It's so joyful to watch. It's so hopeful. I feel like Noah watching, thinking, like, maybe that does exist out there. And just all your little, like, all the little moments. I have to ask, like, it was obviously improvised in the scene coming up now in episode 4 where you did the backwards beso.
Yes. I throw all kinds of stuff at Carlos, and he's wonderful because he just catches it. He just lets, you know, you never know what's going to come out. And I think that's the fun of playing when you're an actor, right? Like, you just kind of do things. Like, you that's the connection of like the yumminess that's not written on the page that we get to bring to a scene because of who we are as actors and who they hired, you know? And I want to sing your praises, Mama, because you've been doing some beautiful work. So touching, that beautiful scene, especially you did with your mom. And it was so beautiful, Nat. And I know I told you, I was so proud of you. Because it's just, you know, it's not easy to dig up that stuff and to share it with the world, you know, and be private in public.
Yeah.
So kudos to you, baby girl.
Gracias. Welcome. Thank you so much. I am really proud of myself, but I also feel like you being proud of me means so much, because I feel people always ask me, how are you and Noah very similar? And well, I was raised, and this is no disrespect to my parents who really tried their best and were amazing parents, but there was a lot of pressure on me when I was younger to just, like, you know, just pressure to perform, to be good. Yeah. And so I always really craved that, like, unconditional love, and I craved their approval. And so there's something, and you are so our matriarch and our mother, even though I know I say I hate saying that, because you and me are, like, age-wise sisters, but, like, there's something so maternal.
Not really. You could be my child.
No, I don't think so. But maternal, you're funny. There's just something so maternal about you. So to kind of, like, bask in the sunshine of your love and praise, I think I speak for all of us when I say that that's, like, so healing. And I think that's why people keep tuning in, because they, like, want to imagine that Marie maybe is their mother and Rafael is their father. And
absolutely.
And Noah does too. And tonight we're going to see what happens when the two worlds meet.
Yes, absolutely. You said that perfectly, perfectly. And, you know, a couple of people, like, were like, oh, well, what's Noah's background? And, you know, where does she come from? And I was like, you guys have to stay tuned, because you're going to see what her world is. And you've, like I said, it's been lovely watching you play that mix of, like, you know, the curiosity, you're so endearing, and yet you're guarded, you know? And that is Noah's heart right now, because of everything that, and I'm not speaking to your character, but this is what we've shared, you know, that she doesn't have that warm love and family and stuff. So that's something I think that we all crave. And I think our beautiful little show, like we've said, brings a lot of that to the world, especially right now. And, you know, we've all been quarantining, all the cast. We Zoom a lot. We love each other so much. And it's a blessing and a gift for us to be working together. And it's people just a gift,
that,
you know?
People ask that, because the chemistry is, if I do say so myself, the chemistry on this show between everybody is off the charts. Yes. And that's something that's, like, that's hard to get. Like, you can have really talented actors, but it doesn't always work when you throw everybody into, you know, one pot. Yep. And with us, it just felt instant, right? Can you speak maybe a little more about, like, how we all just, like, instantly kind of melded?
Yes. Well, actually, I think one of the first times was during the pilot when we shot it in Atlanta. And actually, I was like, we were in the lobby and everybody's meeting or whatever, but
the lobby.
A few days later, I was like, we're going to have a cast dinner and I'm going to arrange it and put it together and we're all going out. Right? Remember that? And then afterwards, we were dancing in the lobby together. And I just, you know, being on several shows, I know how important chemistry is and how important it is to lay the foundation of relationship. And you know, because we're going to be spending a lot of time together as a cast. And if it's not there, if that yummy stuff is not there, it just goes and nobody's interested. And the audience is smart. They can see it. They can feel it, you know?
Yeah.
And so we had the best time. And that was it, right? That was the beginning of everything.
That was the beginning. And I want to paint a picture for people who weren't there. So kudos to you for organizing this kind of, like, cast night out. But afterwards, it was like you, me, Dan Bukatinski. Was Carlos there?
Yeah, we were all there.
Carlos, we were all there.
Rasmus, David Del Rio.
Oh, that's
Lisa,
right. Oh, yeah, everybody was there. Okay.
Everybody was there.
The lobby, sorry, because I was really just focused on you and Dan dancing at that time, because I was just like, I cannot believe I get to work with these people. But I think we were in the lobby of the hotel where we were filming, and, you know, they were playing, like, some kind of funky music. And as a laugh, like, one of us got up to dance, and usually, like, other people would just kind of sit around and watch and laugh, but not this cast. Within 1 minute, everyone was up.
Everybody.
And we were all, like, getting down, and the people in this hotel lobby were like,
everybody was like, okay.
Yeah, and you could tell there were a lot of your fans and Scandal fans, and Atlanta was where I had filmed Dynasty, so there were people going, like, Wait, what is happening here? We were having a lovely party.
It was pretty awesome. It was pretty awesome. I know. And I shot Mary Jane there for 5 seasons.
And oh, yeah. That's where you shot that. Okay. So, yeah, we all had, and I think Dan shot 24 there. So, look, a lot of love for us in Atlanta. So, thank you.
A lot of love.
That was just a precursor to what would be an amazing year for us of like a lot more dancing, a lot more love, a lot more family time.
Yes. And also, I'm sure your fans know because you're good at letting them know, but Nat was teaching us a lot about like the local food in Puerto Rico where we shot the show. She actually introduced us to a few restaurants in Puerto Rico that use the local food and you know, make it like, you know, so that nothing's being wasted.
Yeah.
And that was really awesome. And, you know, I'm Puerto Rican. And I didn't even know that. I was like, okay, I didn't know that. So it was great. I really feel like we all got fed from Puerto Rico.
How amazing was it to be filmed somewhere that is your heritage? You know, like I felt like that must be so special for you.
Amazing and magical, honestly, amazing and magical. I can't even describe it. I can try to describe it in words, but it was sort of a reawakening of myself, like the deepest part of myself and who I am as a person. And like it made me realize, Lisa, don't doubt and don't allow other people to make you feel like your joy and your immediate response to just go like this with people and be loving and stuff, because that's how I am. Don't let people, like, don't allow people's discomfort make you think that that's not a good thing. And my family's like that. So being in Puerto Rico, I was like, oh my God, everybody in Puerto Rico's like that. That's where it comes from, you know, and so many other funny things that I always tease about, like my big butt. I was like, oh, everybody here got a big butt. I belong in Puerto Rico. So it was really, honestly, it was soul awakening for me. It really was.
You really are the quintessential Boricua. Just like you're, now that I have lived there, I feel like I can pinpoint what that is. And it's true, like everybody there is so alive and happy and like joyful and fun. And like, you know, I'm super proud to be Peruvian. But I feel like if I could also be Puerto Rican, like if I could have that as well, I would be just a perfect human. Because they're just they're just the best
people. See, you already have Boricua in you, mommy, because you spent so much time there. You're adopted into the family.
It's true.
Exactly.
Wow, making me miss it. Exactly. Okay, so we should get to the episode because it's a goodie tonight. It's the first time our worlds collide. Is there anything you want to tease? Yes. People have been asking. So some of the questions are like, what is the family going to think of Noah? And let's talk about Mari specifically. Like, how do you think she feels at this point?
I think, you know, I think Mari is absolutely the typical mom in general, but in Latina mom terms, because she is a Latina. I absolutely
What is a Latina mom?
We tend to be a little too much in your business, I think.
Thanks for clarifying.
I heard somebody call on the phone. I heard the message. Get your hair set. So I definitely think Mari has a lot of that. I've learned to water that down, you know, pull it back a little bit. But Mari definitely has a lot of that. And she's very protective of her family and her children. So she's kind of leery of people. I mean, even someone like Vanessa, who's played by the wonderful Michelle Ventimiglia, even someone like Vanessa is like still a little tricky to Mari. Like she's not 100% convinced, you know? And so it's a process, I think, for her. And I mean, think about it. Like her kids are still, you know, her kids are older and she still disciplines them. She'd still be telling them what to do, right?
Which is so typical of... I love the flame. Right. It was so Latin. I think every Latin child saw that and could appreciate.
Totally. And David Del Rio, who plays Mateo, who's amazing and hilarious singing. I sing all the cast. I'm getting to each one of them, but he's so freaking funny. Him and I have such a banter back and forth, Mari and Mateo. and we really have a lot of fun acting out scenes and stuff. But anyway, to say about the whole Noah thing, you know, Madi being an ex-showgirl, ex-performer, that whole limelight thing is kind of interesting to her because that's the world she comes from. So I think she's very interested in that world, you know, and she wants as cautious as Rafael is, played by the wonderful Carlos Gomez, who plays by Rafi Trullo. Anyway, so he's a little bit more cautious. He's a little more, you know, kind of being careful about things. Whereas Madi is very inviting to Noah, and it's very exciting to her. So we'll see how that goes. What do you think?
Well, you know, Latin mother-in-laws can go either way. Oh, no. Am I back? You're good to me.
I think you froze for a minute, Mommy. Is it me? Am I freezing or are you?
You're live. Am I frozen? Because I'm fine and you're fine. I think I'll come back. We just got to wait. Maybe I'm good
because you're freezing on my phone. Yeah, you're freezing.
I'm not frozen on mine. People watching, am I frozen?
Wait, you're coming back, kind of, sort of.
You were back.
Coming back, kind of, sort of. Let's see. You are back.
Yeah, y'all are good. Okay. Am I good? Nat is all right. Okay.
The fans will tell us. All right. Can you guys see us okay? Or are
Lisa's
freaking?
Frozen.
Are we like...
Dang. I think we're going to come back. So okay. Brookie, my Not best friend,
Lisa
Brookie. Freezing. She says we're good.
Okay. Lisa, okay. Frozen. I'm
okay.
Freezing.
Look. So... I think Noah is nervous for sure because Latin mother-in-laws can go either way and they can be either really warm and welcoming or like very protective of their sons. And look, I think what Lewis said about Noah in the first episode,
something's wrong with the internet again. Oh, God.
Oh, shoot. What if I move inside? How's this? Better, guys? Okay. I think what Lewis said about Noah in the first episode is true.
Wait, she's moving. Let's see. All is good. There you go. Oh, my God.
Okay. I think what he said about Noah... Now? Yeah. In the first episode...
Okay, sorry, honey. Okay.
...is true that she has broken a lot of hearts in the past and that... not intentionally, but, you know, like... she's maybe not aware of the effect that she has in people's lives, and for her things can be pretty casual and she can move on, but obviously the person she's left behind is like didn't find it so casual. And I think she's aware that what she has with Daniel is different, but at the same time, like, she knows a mother-in-law like is going to be protective of her son. And, you know, she's aware that she has been a tornado coming into this man's life and this man's family's lives. And so she's definitely nervous and she knows like she's a good person and she can charm people, but she's not like looking to just like charm. She's looking for a family. So I think she's showing up tonight in her most like genuine, sincere, authentic self. And willing to be like honest and vulnerable in the hopes that she can like find a home and a family here, you know? And so, but like nervous, right? Like
right.
That's pretty nerve wracking to meet the parents.
Yeah. I think some really good stuff happens tonight.
It's going to be a good episode, guys. It's really, yeah. It's one of my favorites because it's like up until now, we've only seen Daniel and Noah and then the Garcias. And so for the two worlds to collide is funny, shocking. Any other adjectives?
Funny, shocking, and surprising. We're going to find out some surprises that, you know, we didn't know. And intense. It gets intense, don't you think? And by the way, I wanted to mention very quickly that this episode is directed by the wonderful Erica Dunton. She was incredible. So cool to work with. I really enjoyed working with her. So
he was amazing. Yeah. And how good is it to work with a female director? And yeah. I will tease as well that there is a very sexy scene between Daniel and I at the top of the episode. Even more reason to watch it live tonight, guys, at 10 p.m.
Ooh, it's like, going to be on fire, y'all. It's going to be on fire.
Yes. But basically, they're like, on love David Del Rio's things.
On. Let's see who's on with us. Let's see. David Del Rio. I think Dan.
Yes. Well, say something fun. But I wanted to say something funny, guys.
Let's see.
But I just wanted to say that how nice it was having a female director direct the lovemaking thing. I can't read and tell a story. You read and tell me what they're saying.
I have a cookie in my eye.
But I don't know. Erica Dunton was directing our.
Oh my God, this is so funny. Somebody wrote, "God gave you everything but my number." I love that.
Someone wrote in my DMs, "If Corona doesn't take you out, can I?"
Oh my God, you guys are the best. I love the fans. They come out with the funniest stuff. Georgina Riley's on. What's up, Georgie? What's up?
Okay, we'll take
Tiki on here.
We'll take questions now.
Melissa Escobedo, who's running our Baker in the Beauty Instagram today, right?
Yeah, guys, go check out her. She's doing a takeover. She's so funny, man. She's one of the funniest people I know.
So funny.
Guys, if you want to ask us questions, we're open to answering them now. I had some saved, but now I'm away from my laptop. Do you remember any that people had asked you?
I know that somebody asked, what was your favorite episode to shoot? Which character would you like to play besides your own? And then,
how would you answer that?
Well, I actually answered, I want to be Vanessa because she's like, I was like, that's fun. That's just fun. You know what I mean?
Can I tell you that I almost auditioned for Vanessa instead of Noah?
Really?
My agents, I had just had a meeting with them and we were moving into pilot season. And I was like, guys, I'm sick of just having, like, don't just send me up for the pretty girl. I want to do other shit. I want to be the funny one. I want to be anything but just the pretty girl. And they're like, oh, well, then there's this great part you might like. She's a girlfriend. And I was listening to the, like, role description. I was like, that could be cool. But, you know.
Yeah, but she's still pretty. So you get to do both. See, that's why I like Vanessa.
Because you know what?
Sexy is all heck, but she is boss lady.
I actually have a lot of role envy. Huh? She does get to do the fun shit. Like that character is so fun. Like every time she comes on screen, I'm rooting for her. I'm Team Vanessa, in case anybody was wondering.
I love it. I love it. You know, I have days where I'm Team Vanessa, which I want to be Vanessa. I have days where I'm team Belisa too, Natalie, because I love her and you know how she's banters with her brothers, right? And then I have days where I'm like, I want to be Noah walking on the beach with my hair blowing and wearing sexy dresses and being 30 years younger, no 20, whatever, 20 years younger. I'm like, I want to be Noah too. Look, we have fun characters on this show, and that's that. It's like everyone has something amazing and interesting to play, right? It's just amazing. And
everyone is so good. What were you going to say?
I was going to say that Dean, Georgeris, our creator, and the writer's room, which is, we got a lot of Latinos in the writer's room.
Yeah, actually, round of applause like for the writers.
Latinos. Anyway, they really give us a lot of freedom with these characters. I really think that also makes the magic because they allow us to just bring so much of what we feel and everything. And even with little improvs that we do just kind of make it magical. So we get to have a lot of fun doing that.
We do. And I have to say, our writer's room is so amazing. Like, I've never worked on a show before where I received the script and was, like, laughing audibly when I was reading it. And, like, just, it was just, it's just getting better and better, you know? But I also have to say, that what we do, I wish we could show people some of the script pages. Maybe Dean will let us do that so that the fans could see what we do that's on top of what they give us. Because right. I think that's what makes the show so special is all the like little improvised and like those little moments. And I would love the fans to know like how much extra we layer it, you know, layer on top of it.
Absolutely. Absolutely. It's all the yummy stuff. The yummy stuff. Do you want to pick out some questions? I think they started doing some question stuff. I wonder why my light is so damn hot.
Is there a special connection being a Latino cast? 100%. Like, there's, it does feel very special to be telling this very quintessential Latin story. And at the same time, I know so many people are tuning in who are not Latinos and they love the show like just as much. Yeah. So I know it's
thank
not
you
like
to the non-Latinos. Yes.
Yes. Thank you to the non-Latinos for tuning in as well. Like people from Australia, I'm getting the best messages from people from Australia who you couldn't get further away from Latin America who were like, oh, I'm loving the pastelitos and like just like they're so funny getting into it.
I love that. And that's hysterical.
It just goes to show that like the love, laughter and family are universal, and whether you're Latino or not, this is a beautiful show.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Okay. I agree with you.
Okay. Questions, guys. Would either of you like to direct? I don't feel like I want to direct. Like
I want to direct. I definitely want to direct.
You would be great.
I would love to direct. One day, God willing, one day. Ooh, we got Tennessee up in the house. We got France. We got Slovakia. I saw somebody.
Guys, send us your questions.
Let's see. Sorry about my hot light today. I look like a bulb. I don't know what happened, but.
People want to know about your alcohol cabinet behind you.
Oh, y'all, you know what? Everybody asked me about this. It's the best internet connection that I have in my house. That's why we do it over here. But yes, we do enjoy spirits every once in a while, especially during quarantine.
I was wondering why that was always your backdrop. I was like, the bar. Okay.
I know. Look. I'm guerrilla warfare over here with this whole Insta Live Zooming thing. But no, seriously, this is the one spot where I get the most internet. Everywhere in the house, it just cuts off. It doesn't work. I've had the hardest time downloading our little videos and stuff. It just won't work. So, our fan pages are here again. I want to say shout out and thank you to all our fan pages because you guys rock. And I try to thank them every time because they're so incredible. And they work so hard to put our stuff out there.
Yes. The fan response has been so beautiful. I want to thank everybody, too. It's so nice to see it growing and yes. People making little edits. And, like, it shows that people are invested in a story. So we're telling a story that is, like, compelling and believable. And people are really along for the ride, which is so nice. I want to know how you felt when you first got the audition. You auditioned, right? I auditioned. Did you audition?
I did audition.
How did you feel when you first got the role and you read the script?
Well, I tell you, I don't know if I ever told you this story, but Carlos Gomez and I have been friends forever, as you know. We know all the same people. You know, we're in that small community of Latino actors. Anyway, so Carlos and I were together, my girlfriend Justina Machado from One Day at a Time, which is another fabulous show you guys should be watching. We were at the premiere of like her second season, I think, right? So Carlos and I said hello to each other. He saw me walk in and we ended up sitting next to each other. And he says, hey, have you read the script for The Baker and the Beauty yet? I said, no, I haven't. I said, what is it? I'm your biggest fan too, Dan. And he said, oh, it's a great story. I think I'm going to be signing on to play the husband, and I think you would be great to play Mari, my wife. And I was like, oh, okay. I said, well, I'll be calling my agent first thing in the morning just to see. And I literally called my agent the next morning, and literally she was like, oh, my God, I just emailed you an appointment for it, and I emailed you the script. Well, I had been reading a lot of pilots, and nothing was jumping out at me. Nothing was really saying, this is the one. And honestly, Nat, this is the truth. I was praying. I was saying, God, please send me something where it's like a This Is Us. I want to play the mother in a family. I want to play like something where it's just, I get to use all parts of myself, and I just love the family, and it's normal, and it's this. I kid you not, I'm not making that up. That is the God's honest truth. And this falls on my lap. And I went in and I had my first audition, and I saw a bunch of my girlfriends there. So I felt really good because I was like, this is a good project. And then I had to leave right away because my grandma had passed away, and I had to fly to New York that night.
Wow.
So I flew to New York. I literally got a phone call on Sunday, I think. And it was my agent saying, they want you to test on Tuesday. And I was like, oh, wow, okay, awesome. So I was super excited. And who's at my test but Carlos Gomez?
Had he already booked it?
What?
Had he already booked it? Or
he had already booked it. He
was their chemistry reading with you.
He tested with me, yep. And we were on fire, baby. We were like, woo.
Can you tell me,
like, Lisa was testing that day too. She was sitting in the waiting room, and there was another girl testing too. And so, and look, Belisa got it. So it was, it just was a dream come true for me.
I didn't know all this. I love that we saved the story for now. So your abuelita had passed. So you're doing the audition with this, like, your matriarch has passed. Maybe she kind of passed on some energy to you to kind of like, she passed on the baton. Wow. How beautiful.
Absolutely.
And what kind of, like, any jokes or any kind of anything cute about the audition process when you were, like, bringing Mari to life, like, that you want to share? I'm so curious.
You know, yeah. You know what? Come here. Say quick hello. I want to answer that because say hello to my handsome son who's in love with Nat.
Hi.
Kelly.
This Hi. Is my handsome
You're
son.
You're awesome on the show. You're awesome.
Thank you. Thank you so much. You have amazing parents.
Yes,
he's
I
so
do.
Cute.
Thank you.
He's so cute. That's
he is a dog.
It was really he's blurry, but that's which one is that? That's not Max.
That's the oldest. That's Scott. That's my oldest.
Oh, Scott. Okay. So, hey, Scott.
So for the audition, you know what? First of all, I brought my own fan. I have one. It connects to my phone. I brought that into the audition. I have my own fan. I was like, look, this is real. I'm really going through this. So I'm going to use it in every way I can. And, you know, I just decided to have fun with the audition. Like, I knew who this woman was. I immediately knew Mari. And I was like, I'm Mari. I am Mari. I don't have to work too hard for this. And I just, you know, I played her the way I really wanted to. Like someone I would want to see playing a mom. Like I just wanted to see her have that sass and that fun and that joy and that heat for her man and that thing. But also, you know, I did a scene, one of my audition scenes was the scene where we talk about my daughter. And it was a very intense scene to do both.
Oh no, you froze.
I froze. Am I still
Yeah, but
frozen?
Now you're back. Now you're back. Now you're
Am
back.
Am I still frozen?
Yeah, you're back. So the scene with your daughter.
Am I back? Oh,
yeah.
God. This is why they can't replace people. So what, honey? What?
The scene with your daughter.
Ooh. Am I frozen again, Nat?
No. So you had to do the scene. Were you
right,
talking
so
about
I did
Natalie?
The scene with my daughter. Yes. And, and it was a much more like dramatic and intense scene. So I got to do both. I got to do the playful one and the other one.
Oh, well, you do both so well. And guys, there's a scene tonight. Well, so filming with them was, so I had to wait like a good 9 months to have a scene with these guys, with the family, because from the time we shot the pilot and all first met to the time we got to episode number 4 was like pretty much 9 months. So there was a big build up towards working together. And there's a scene where Maritz tells a story of how she met and fell in love with Rafael. And it is such a, it was such a master performance to watch as an actress. Like, it was like the best acting class ever. And it was like take after take. We were all, me, Victor, Belisa, David, all just sitting there, just like, just in awe of this performance. And even Erica, the director, said like, she made a comment like, you're about to witness something. Lucky you guys, because you get about to witness something very special. Like, and it was just this feeling of us all like getting to, because you and Carlos are our, you are our like, you know, I don't, the elders is not the right word, but just like the OGs.
Yes, absolutely, that's mama. That's word. Okay. Yeah, absolutely. I take, by the way, I take pride in that. I don't like people calling me old lady because I ain't an old lady, but
definitely
I take pride in wisdom and experience, and I appreciate that. And I feel honored to be able to, like, you know, be there for one of you guys, like in something that, you know, maybe you're unsure of. And I want to be somebody that you guys can lean on and feel comfortable with and come to and embrace you and be like, you got this in whatever aspect of your lives, you know. That to me is my responsibility as someone who's lived, you know, in this career for 40 years now. I've been an actress, so I feel honored. I love it. I love you guys.
I can't wait for everybody to see the scene, these scenes tonight. Okay, I'm going to address this because it comes up a lot, because I know that there are a lot of Dynasty fans, and everybody's like, Crystal, OG Crystal. And I just want to say that I acknowledge you guys, and thank you so much. So many of you have jumped onto this new show and supporting this my new project. And not to say you can't support both shows, because Dynasty is still a great show. And I think they're going on to season 4 now. And I wish everybody the best. I love everybody, especially Liz Gilley. She's like my sister. And people always, you know, like to comment about it. And I feel like maybe it would be nice, because there are lots of Dynasty fans, to share about my transition to become Noah. So I left Dynasty after season 1. And there was like 9 months before I booked this role, Noah Hamilton in Baker and the Beauty. And during those 9 months, I had a real like, just like, you know, it was a time for me to really dig deep as a woman, as an actress, and think like the same as you. There was a lot of prayer involved. And I was like, God, I am really just ready for the role where I don't have to like force anything that's not me. I really am ready to just bring my essence to a role. And I had, like, actually same to you, I had a really beautiful moment of prayer, because I know that we're both sisters of prayer, on a beach in Miami around December. The sun was rising, and I was like really just praying. I said, I'm ready for the next role. I think I've learned what I needed to learn, and I trust you, God. And literally a few weeks later, this project, the audition, came to me. And same as you, when I read, I didn't even have to, like, I was this person. I mean, I'm not like a super famous celebrity, but there's a lot of I think maybe the notorious, but not like, I wouldn't want to be as famous as Noah, put it that way. I'm happy to play a famous person and not be one. But who she was underneath the fame, I really resonated with, like unable to like make it work with love and men having a really hard time being with her and her being let down by men and meeting somebody who was just like a good, solid guy, what she'd like, and the family that she craved. There's so many parallels that yeah. when I first auditioned for it, it was what when I was auditioning for it, it felt like you said with Mari, it felt really easy to put this character on. And yeah. there was, and then when I ended up booking it, I was like, it was just amazing to me because it was everything that I had asked God for. And then we were filming a scene which didn't make it to the pilot, which I hope the producers will put in the second season. Should we get one? If you guys tune in at 10 p.m. tonight, we hopefully will. But it's where Noah's doing, it's one of Noah's commercials. And you guys are supposed to be watching it in that first scene in episode one where Carlos, where Rafael says to Mari, that's how your mom looked when I first met her. Well, what that was originally a commercial of Noah's bikini line, but they decided to save it for later. But anyway, that commercial, when we were filming it, it was on that very beach where I watched the sunrise and had a prayer. Yes, I haven't told you that story either.
That's amazing.
No, that is like amazing. What are the chances? I had just been there like 2 months earlier, having a little cry, letting go, letting Dynasty go. Because you know, like when you start a show and you and start a character, they become very intimate with you. You're the character and the people that you work with. And so whenever you transition, there's always like a letting go, and then you have to be ready for the new one. So I had that moment on the beach, and then that's where I filmed the commercial with David Frankel. It was all just like. And all of us have a story like this about this show where it just very much feels like a destiny for all of us and just something really like magical, like pieces of the puzzle coming together.
That's how God works, you know, that's how God works. And he puts us in each other's lives too. And he puts the right people in your life, you know, and it's such a blessing. And, you know, the beautiful thing I will say too about you and I just personally, right. I really feel like you and I have been able to get much closer because we've had beautiful, deep conversations about being a woman, being an actress, being a mother, you know, and, you've been able to be honest with me and I've been able to be honest with you. And I feel like honesty is a beautiful thing because that's when you really love somebody and that's when you really care about somebody. You know, you can speak truth with each other and you can be there for one another and, you know, and still love and not, you know, have anything else behind it and just have it be that. And I think that, for me, I know, like, playing Mari as well, like, I was telling Dean, the creator, I was like, I really hope that Mari can have some scenes with Noah about mother, being a mother, and, you know, maybe have that beautiful scene where, you know, Noah gets to break down a little bit to Mari, and Mari can, you know, kind of receive Noah and be there for her. Wouldn't that be great? I mean,
it could happen season one. People have to tune in, but we're hoping for more season two for sure. Yes. And I think it really speaks, hi birdies. It really speaks, like you said, to the real relationship we have, which is so honest and real and very rare, you know, like there's, especially on sets, there can be a lot of like pettiness and like, BS and like we don't do that. We like we speak our truths. We, you know, like we honor the other person, we honor their truth, and it's really powerful. And you kind of really set the tone for that on our show as well. And so thank you. And that, and I think that's why I think I would imagine Noah and Mari to have as real and honest and deep of a conversation as Natalie and Lisa.
Yes, absolutely. I'm pushing for that. Absolutely.
Yeah, Dean, are you listening?
I don't know if he's on. I saw we got a few texts.
Guys, thank you so much for tuning in. I know we had like 6 Instagram lives today. You guys are the best. We'll take should we take a few more questions and then let you guys
honey,
get your popcorn?
Why don't you do that? Because this is the longest live I've done. This is amazing, and they're still going.
Okay, give us some more questions, Bella. Guys. We'll stay on for a few more minutes. Oh, people sending us love and prayers. Thank you. You know, that's what, another thing that I'm so touched by is so many people saying, like, how they're going through tough times with what's going on. Yeah. And this show is like a little ray of sunshine to them. That makes us so happy. Right, Lisa?
Yes, absolutely. I've been saying it over and over again, how blessed I feel that our show can bring some happiness and some joy for a little while for people, you know. I just know a lot of people that are going through a lot during this pandemic and who've lost loved ones and who are, you know, our first responders, our heroes. God bless them and protect them, Lord. And so many people who, you know, have to deal with people who have passed and their families. It's been tough, man. It's been tough. And I just say thank you, first of all, to the first responders, and sending prayers from our show, from all of us, to those who, you know, have had losses and who are struggling with this pandemic. And thank you for tuning into our show, even with everything that's going on, that we can bring you some warmth and love and joy. That for me, that's everything. And I know you feel the same way. Our cast feels that way.
Totally. Yes. Yeah. We would never have imagined or wanted to come out during a time like this, but the fact that it has been real medicine for people is a blessing. Someone said that she loves you and Christina since Thayina days, and it was the first time she'd seen herself represented on TV.
Thank you so much. Let's see.
And my favorite episode. So favorite episode for me was episode 8, because it's another episode where Noah and the family all get together. And I don't think it's a spoiler to reveal. Well, it's some kind of a party for somebody in the family, but I won't go any further. But we all get together and there's dancing.
Yes, there's more dancing. Something we love doing.
Let's see. So that was one of my favorite. What about your favorite episodes?
My favorite is the same one, actually. The same episode. That's my favorite one. The same as the one you just chose. And I love that in that episode, it's almost like every character had such awesome stuff like going on, you know? We all had really great stuff going on and stuff, great stuff to do. I love that. Somebody asked, what's your best memory? What's your best memory on the show? Like, what was your favorite scene, or what was your, you know, something that you will hold on to, I guess, forever?
Oh, best. Ooh, that's hard.
I know.
The best one.
There are so many.
I can't think of one, because my whole time there was honestly, like, it was some of the toughest 6 months of my life, but also the most beautiful. Like, I had a lot of personal stuff going on that was tough, but then the people, the way that my family cast showed up for me in that time, and the people of Puerto Rico and the island, made it like the definition of bittersweet, like going through a lot personally, but at the same time so loved and held by all you guys. So I can't pick one. Do you have one?
Oh my goodness, I think, like you, it's hard to pick one. But I think, without spoiling anything, I have two favorites that are coming up. And one is with Belisa's character, Natalie, and one is with Carlos Gomez's character.
Okay, I can't really
give it away, because it hasn't aired yet.
You guys have to watch. Oh, I didn't know they were talking about on the show. Okay, so people are asking if we're going to address Natalie's sexuality tonight. It will be addressed. We won't say how, but it's going to be talked about for sure.
Right.
Which is funny, because my mom was saying, like, how is Maddie going to feel if she finds out Natalie's gay? I said, probably exactly how you would feel, Mom. and my mom was like, exactly. It's like mixed emotions for Latina moms, no?
Yeah. I was actually just talking about that today earlier, because it's wonderful how, you know, we didn't go the stereotypical route, and as usual on our show, I think, you know, and you want to see Maddie go through the journey of what that looks like, right? When she's got all these dreams and stuff for her daughter, Being a mom of a daughter myself, my daughter is 16 years old. We're very close. And me, like, not being able to connect with her or, you know, feel like I'm losing any kind of connection to her is the most terrifying thing to me, like, ever. Like, even when I was shooting in Puerto Rico the 5 months, I was petrified. Like, I just had to FaceTime her all the time. And she was like, Mom, she was like, I'm fine. Mommy, I'm fine. I was like, are you sure you're fine? Because I miss you like crazy and I need you. So that's, it's really, really, you know, it's like feeling like, you know, if you don't know your child, you know, you feel like a disconnect, and it's just awful for a parent, you know.
I think that's the fear. It's not like, oh, my daughter is gay. It's that, like, I'm going to, something, like, something we had is now lost. Like, okay, what I thought it was is now gone. It's a, you're grieving the death of an idea, but it's not necessarily angry that they're gay. It's just 15 years of dreams and fantasies and projections, you know?
Right.
I get it.
Yeah.
Oh, well, you guys are amazing. Wait, Nat, are you Latina? Of course.
Yes,
soy peruana. Aunque no hable español, soy Latina. Y aunque soy culo challenged, I'm still a Latina.
She has a cute culito, people. Don't let her trick you, okay?
Look me up. Not everybody.
Yes, if I walk around like that in my house, I might burn something.
You crack me up. I want to end. That's actually my favorite. I'm going to end on this for me. That's my favorite moment on set is the time I made Lisa Vidal cry with laughter. And it was when I mentioned that I don't know how it came about, but I came up with this term for myself of being culo challenged. Okay. Now culo, for everybody who doesn't know, means booty. And there's this big stereotype that Latinas have the big Lisa Vidal booty. And that is mostly true. There are some Latinas, como yo, that are culo challenged, but are still Latina, okay? And I need to represent for all my culo challenged Latinas out there. We are a minority, but we our voices still count, and our culos still count.
Yes, they do. Yes, they do. You are stunning and beautiful, and your culito is just fabulous. I
can't have everything, guys, and I'm okay with it now. You know, I'm 35. Like, it's okay. My culo is what it is.
People, I know, you're 35, and you look like you're 19, for crying out loud.
So same with you. We both got those good Latina indigenous genes. Okay. My Taina sister, I love you. Everybody tonight, tune in, 10 p.m.
Thank you. See you guys tonight.
We'll be live tweeting.
Love you.
Ciao, everybody.
Bye, mommy.
Ciao, mi amor. Te quiero.
Ciao, baby. God bless you.